it going again? Today I got something for you that you're gonna like. You ever know when you have a fuse blown in your RV, which I had last year, which it drove me nuts, but it blew in the RV. It was for I was reinstalling the radio, actually. Anyway, the fuse blew, and to fit up under the dashboard, you got to be a contortionist to do that, and I'm not one. So I found something online that I think every RVer should have or replace in their RV. They're called smart fuses from Littelfuse, actually. What happened with these fuses, why they're so different, is that when a fuse blow, this fuse glow, actually. So you know immediately that which fuse is blown. So what I'm going to do is replace my fuses and turn them over with these smart fuses. Maybe I'll do one little section first and then I'll come back and do the other section another day where you have the mini fuses here. Actually, the mini fuses, you'll find those in the front of the rig. You'll find these here. In this case, I have them in the back. So that's what we're going to do today, folks. So I have some rubber gloves. I have part of my PPE, my safety glasses. So what you want to do first is come up here to the front. I had the generator running. So I'm going to turn off the generator. And then I have the chassis and the coach batteries. I'll turn those off. Now, there's no power right now flowing through Tim Rover. So what I'll do, I'll take these out. Just gonna replace the 15 amp and that one 5 amp. So the 15 amps here are blue. They look a little bit different because the normal fuses you have, they're a little bit clear. If you noticed here, you can't even see inside of there to see if a fuse is blown. So we're gonna take these back to the back. Oh, forgot about my gloves here. Let me put that on real quick. Put these on. Be on the safe side. And I think these safety glasses can fit over my prescription glasses here. Yeah, that's not too bad. So let's go and swap out these fuses here. So with this fuse here, I'm going to turn this here. In here you see it's not too dark. I have 1, 2, 3, I think it's 10 fuses and 10 15 amp and 1 5 amp. So what I'm going to do is take all of these 15 amps out and replace that 5 amp. We'll start from the top. Kind of hard to get out. I'm going to put this 15 amp fuse here that glows when it's blown. It's kind of hard to get out of here. They're snug in here too. We'll keep going. So what I'll do here, I'm going to speed this up a little bit just because you don't want to watch me take out all 10 fuses actually. I finally got all the fuses the old 15 amps and replace them with these smart fuses here. So what I'm going to do, there's one more. There's a 5 amp that I'm going to replace with this 5 amp. It looks a little bit like an orange opposed to, like, this one looks like brownish color. So I'm going to replace that one. So this one here shouldn't be that hard to get. This one here shouldn't be that hard to get out. Let's see what we get here. Okay, we got that out, that 5 amp. We're going to replace it with this 5 amp smart fuse. So what I'm going to do is check them all and make sure they all are nicely firm in place here. Doesn't matter which way the 15 symbol goes, actually. You can put them neatly if you want to, but in my case, I'm just going to leave them like they are. But it doesn't matter which way to go in. So we're looking good. So now I'm going to replace the cover on this here. And we'll start her up and we'll go from there. Nice and tight. Yep, she's tight, I think. We'll give it one more little turn. There you go. So this here is the 12 volt fuse panel. We're only replacing the old fuses, I should say, with the smart fuses. Close that up. I'm going to go ahead and turn back on the power up again. It looks like all the lights are working, as you can see. So what we're going to do is turn on that generator, come up here to the front, give her a good start. We'll go back here in the back. Like all the lights are working. So I'm not going to throw these out, give them away. You can never have enough fuses inside your rig. Even though I use these Easy ID or smart fuses. Oh, by the way, these come in different varieties. You have the mini type and you have the standard speed type that they use in vehicles back in the day, even some vehicles today. But in Tim Rover, they're both types, the mini and the spade. So what I do, I keep a lot of, shoebox, I should say. And I keep a fuse puller, the fuse tester. I keep just different types of fuses of all types, even in this little container right here. But what I'm gonna do, back to those ATO fuses, the smart fuse, I'm going to change all of them in Tim Rover. But until then, this is Tim Rover. Talk to you guys in a bit. Don't forget that subscribe button on the top or on the bottom. See you next time. If I got any more innovation ideas or tips for you, I'll be sure to share them with you. Thanks again. Take care. Bye, guys.